What's going on, beautiful people? I hope all is well. Well, I finally got my block back from the machine shop. Well, let me rephrase that. I got a block from the machine shop. Basically, what happened was the machine shop overboard my cylinder. The machine said that its dial bore gauge wasn't set up correctly. Long story short, the cylinders were bored out to 3.906, whereas I requested 3.903. Kind of tweaked about it a little bit, but hey, we got to move on. Got to move on. He provided me with a different block to use. He said the block was good. I'm going to have to take him at his word. Now, some machine shops wouldn't even have the integrity to tell you that they screwed up the block, because they got to produce something to you. You know, they destroyed your product. I feel it's right that they give you something to work with. But that doesn't happen in all cases. I had a friend that he took his block to the machine shop, had him to bore out the cylinders. He didn't find out until he had the engine assembled and back in the vehicle trying to get it running right. It smoked, and basically what he had to do was take it back out, take it back apart, take it to a different machine shop, and they told him, hey, the cylinders were not bored out correctly. So now the question is, would I go back to the same machine shop? Yes, I would, just because he had the integrity to tell me what happened, what he did, and how he can fix it. Can't ask for anything more. Now, if you're taking an engine to a machine shop and want to have some work done, what I recommend that you do is print everything out that you want done to the block. You know, I took it as far as providing them with the torque specs, torque sequence for my ARP studs. And it just make it easy for the machinists. They don't have to go looking for anything. In addition to all that, I made a list of everything that I left with them. So it's more for me than them, because in the event that I'm looking around for something or whatever, I got to print it out and let me know where it is. But what I had done over at the machine shop, I took the front cover, rear cover, the valley plate, the oil pan. I had them to clean those. Didn't really do a good job, but it got most of the dirt and grime off. So something I can work with is less that I have to clean off. Also took the camshaft down there because I had the cam bearings replaced. Had the block deck zero clearance. Basically what I'm saying is the piston and the block deck are even when the piston is at top dead center. Had the mains aligned home for the ARP studs. Now bear in mind, if you go with studs, be sure you have the clearances checked and or changed for the additional clamping force that the studs will provide. But I had it all broke down for them and everything. Human error, it happens. You know, like I said, would I use the machine shop again? Yes, I would, just because the machinist had the integrity to tell me what happened, what he did, and how he can fix the situation. Can't ask for anything more. All right, so what I'm about to do now is clean the block off. Now, some machine shops will clean the blocks or whatnot, but I want you to get familiar with the phrase, trust but verify. Machine shops have a lot of engines passing or a lot of stuff going on in their facility. And I mean, if you've ever been in a machine shop, you can see engine blocks sitting everywhere, metal shavings everywhere. And there's too much room for error. You don't want any dirt or grit or metal particles left in your block I mean, you're just gonna have a disaster in your hands. So basically what I'm gonna do is go ahead and wash it down real quick. I'm gonna use some mild detergent, some Dawn dish detergent to clean the block off. I'm gonna use a brush that I'm gonna chuck up into a drill. Basically what I did, cut the end off and chuck it up in the drill and clean out the cylinders. So I can see the debris in the cylinders. So I know I was gonna have to clean this block up pretty good. So go ahead and get this set up. So what you don't want to do is let the engine air dry or flash, let it dry on its own, because then it'll flash rust. So you gotta work pretty quick to get it dried off. Part is the cylinders. You don't want them to flash rust. The rust get down into the cross hatching, and you wouldn't get a good ring seal. Thank you. Okay, before I go any further, I'm gonna go ahead and replace these oil gallery plugs, water jacket plugs as well. Go ahead and get those knocked out. The reason why I took those out, I knew that I was going to be cleaning the engine myself, and you know, having the machine shop do it, or trusting that the machine shop cleaned the engine with all that metal particle stuff going on in their facility. I just don't trust that I put the block plugs in myself, and then I know a couple things. More importantly, I know that my engine is clean because I cleaned it. Trust but verify. And also, it doesn't require that much to put these water jacket plugs in, or the oil gallery plugs. Using a little regular motor oil to lube up the O-ring on this barbell. This barbell goes in the back of the block. This is one of the critical things that you don't want to leave out, because you won't have any oil pressure. And that's that. All right, we're gonna knock out the one in the front and get this thing going. Going to use the impact just to run these water jacket plugs down. I'm not going to use the impact wrench to torque them down. Just going to get them seated. Water jacket plugs supposed to get torqued down to 44 foot pounds. gonna wipe these bearings down. Seems like this something on me. Not mine, because I just took them out of the pack. But late cranking. Now, it's tempting to spin the crank right now. I wouldn't recommend doing that because there's no assembly lube right there, and you can put some micro scratches in your highly polished surfaces. I wouldn't spin it. That's just a suggestion. All right, so I'm going to get these ran down real quick. Once again, I'm not using the impact wrench to torque these bolts down. All right, so the inners need to get torqued down to 50 foot-pounds. All right, so all my clearance is checked out, about 15 thousandths worth of clearance. What we're gonna do is take the crank out, clean the plastic gauge off, put some assembly lube on the main bearings, and go for final assembly. All right, beautiful people, I'm gonna go for a final wipe down on my main bearings, just to make sure there's no nasties on there, huh? Make sure it's clean. Get get that wiped down. I would recommend change the gloves often, just because handling different components, you can pick up some particulate matter, and you don't want it transferring it to your surfaces, your engine surfaces. So change the gloves quite often. All right, so I'm gonna be using some Permatex Ultra Slick Assembly Lube. Pretty nice stuff. Hey, don't be shy with the lube. I mean, this stuff is important just because on initial startup, you don't have any oil or anything protecting the metal surfaces. I like this stuff, right? It's pretty thick and it stays in place. You want to take your time with that right there. You don't want to gallop any of your surfaces. It just makes for a bad day. Trust me. Be sure you pay attention to the orientation of your main caps. I just put a number 4 on backwards. Once again, it makes for a bad day. Take your time. Don't be in a rat race or anything. Don't do this to impress anyone. I'm not trying to impress anyone. I'm just a guy that digs working on his own stuff. I mean, if I mess it up, there's something to be gained from this learning opportunity. Costly, but still a learning opportunity. Not everybody that did something for the very first time was successful that first time. Like I said, I'm not afraid of failure. It's something you can learn from. change my gloves again. Assembly lube. Now when I did the clearance check, I didn't use any ARP fastener assembly lubricant, but I'm about to do it this time. Just to make sure I get accurate torque on the bolt. Put some on the threads, and I'm also going to put some under the head of the bolt as well. If you're using ARP bolts, I recommend you follow their recommendations. I mean, why wouldn't they know about their own product? I'm just saying. On these tight tolerance engines, I mean, it's very important to follow the manufacturer's recommendations. Bought a big container of this stuff just because any other time I went to go look to buy it, it was always on back order. I already had some, but in little packets, but I just did it just because.
you flick.
Man, come on here. Okay, beautiful people, got everything torqued down to spec, got the side bolts in, the little RTV up under the head so there's no oil seepage. Moment of truth, what you're looking for is just a smooth spin, no notchiness or anything. Look at that, look at that, look at that, look at that. That is so smooth to the touch, baby. Woo, mama, mama. Like that. I like that. Memorize how that feels, okay? As you add the connecting rods on with the pistons and rings, you might have a little bit more resistance, but it still should feel smooth. Mm. Yes, mama.
All right, beautiful people. You saw me clean the block, use my brushes to get good into the cylinder boards, the lifter boards, all the oil passageways. I installed the oil gallery plugs, the one in the front, the barbell in the back, the three that's on the side, and I also installed the water jacket plug. Off camera, I cleaned the crank, made sure I got in good in the all the oil passageways, got that cleaned down real good. Lastly, you saw me check the clearances on the main caps, make sure I had good clearance between the crank and the bearings. Then from there, final assembly, got everything torqued down to ARP torque specs. That's one thing I want to say to you people. I'm not an engine builder, okay? But I live by this principle here. If one person can do it, we all can do it. All it requires is a little imagination, a little ingenuity, and a little bit of know-how. If you agree with me, post it in the comments. All right, last, I'm gonna cover it up with the fresh engine bag so we don't get any foreign matter on it. We have come too far.